once upon a time, there was a lobster, a hippopotamus, a giraffe, and a ferret. Which is almost enough in and of itself. The ferret, who is our hero who we'll be following today, the ferret's name was Ferris. And Ferris had a great family and a great school, and all of a sudden, for absolutely no reason, except for the bizarre twists of life, he had to move. And he had to move to a brand new school. And on this first day of this brand new school, he was really, really nervous because he didn't know anybody. And it was kind of an experimental charter school where they were taking animals from all sorts of different kinds of habitats and they were teaching them all together. And it was a great thing and people were really excited about it. So this is why he ended up in a class with a giraffe, a hippopotamus, a lobster, and himself. But that first day, he started hanging out with these three other people. And they were talking, and then the lobster was talking about how he really enjoyed being a lobster, but he kind of felt a little bound up because he couldn't twist to either side. He had lots of good mobility with his tail, but he was really, his whole body was kind of tight. And the giraffe said, "You know, I hear you. I can go up and down. I have lots, but I can't really twist myself around." And the ferret, in his mind, he's like, "I am so bendy." He was really starting to worry that maybe these people, when the hippopotamus says, "You know, I can't either. I have all of this motion. I can move really fast. My jaw can just huge, but I can't really twist that much." And so it came time for the ferret to speak, and Ferris says, I can't really bend hardly at all either." And so in that moment, he tried to tense up all of his back muscles. And if you've seen them, ferrets, you can almost tie ferrets in a knot. I mean, these are really bendy creatures. But he tried and he froze his spine. And from then on, when he went to school and when he hung out with all his friends, he would just kind of walk all tight and he would have to make these huge wide turns and it was horrible and he started to get the back pain, but he decided that he was going to keep his friends and he wasn't going to tell them just how bendy he was. Now, this school, as I said, was an experimental charter school. And so funding is always an issue. And there was a new administrator came in. He was a jackal. Not all jackals are bad, but this jackal happened to be kind of bad. So he came in and he said, "You know, we're facing a budget crisis. And you people are too expensive. And he said, we're going to test you. And as a result of all this testing, we will decide whether or not we're going to keep this school open." So everybody got really nervous because they loved the school and the families loved the school. And this was a hitherto unknown experiment in interspecies community. And it was going really well. So they studied really hard and the day of the testing was coming up. And all of a sudden, all these four friends, the hippopotamus, the giraffe, the lobster, and the ferret, were on their way into the testing when the jackal popped up and he said, "Oh, we're having a special room for you guys to be tested in." Because the jackal was sneaky and he knew that if those four people, because they were really, really smart, if they didn't take the test, the funding would be obsolete and they could close the school. So he ushered them into a room and the lights were off and all four of them walked in and they said, "But where are the desks?" And all of a sudden the door slams behind them and they were locked in. And he looked around and it was a closet and there was absolutely no way out. The giraffe couldn't pop his head through. All of the walls were steel and so the hippopotamus couldn't kind of rage out. And they all looked around and there was only one way out of this room. There was a sink. There was a sink with a drain just big enough for a ferret to squirrel through. But if you've ever looked underneath the bottom of a sink, there's this really bendy part. And they said, "Well, I bet you can get through, but it's a shame you're not bendy." And he had this moment and he said, "I'm sorry, I've been lying to you." He said, "I'm actually kind of abnormally flexible." And they said, "What? Why would you?" And he said, I was afraid you all were so not bendy, and I'm so bendy." And he said, "Get through the hole!" And so they almost just squished him through the hole, but he was fine. And his back, sure enough, because his destiny was to be bendy, you know, so he was fine. Snaked through the thing, got out, got outside, back around, let them out, and all of a sudden the four of them burst through the doors, because the hippopotamus went first and he's just huge. Burst through the doors, came in, took their test, and sure enough, all of the testing, though it's not the best way to prove educational worth. All of the testing was ruckusly successful, and the school went on to teach more and more generations of interspecies community, and it became a force of connection and wholeness in the world. And the important thing, especially for here, is that all of us, no matter what, no matter how bendy, no matter how stiff, no matter who we love, no matter who we know ourselves to be down in our core, that who we are is a blessing to this world. And all of your families and the wider church family loves you exactly as you are. And that is all we are ever supposed to be.